So for those of you who I haven't met yet, my name's Caitlin. I am with Bangor, and I am one of the 100 contractor consultants that we have. And today we're just going to be going over basic software navigation and learning how to interact with the software itself. So this will kind of be more of the 101 type of course for Stage 100 for those who are either just getting introduced to the software, for those who are feeling a little lost. Software can be very overwhelming at times, and so it's good to just kind of scrape that away and get back to the basics. So that is exactly what this course is designed for. Whether you're watching this live or watching the recording maybe on YouTube later on, still I want to make it available that this is always something to get back in the swing of things, especially when training somebody new, when looking at either adding on something or expanding Stage into different departments in your company. This video will help kind of introduce the whole software to the new person or to somebody who, like I said, is feeling a little lost or overwhelmed. So let me back out actually. Let me start from scratch. So mine will look a little bit different than your guys's, but first on your guys's desktop, you guys will have the icon for Stage 100 Contractor. This is not a cloud-based software, and so that means that it's hosted on a server that is either on-premise or off-premise. And so either you guys will remote in to your guys' server and access it on the server directly, or you will have an icon on your desktop to access the software. So first, I'm just going to double-click here. The way that the software is set up is that it is a SQL version, so everything that you guys type in and save on your version will be saved and stored on a database, which is on the server. So first, we're going to connect. Once you guys are set up as a user, this will become very easy for you to connect. You'll just hit the button. No password needed, nothing super special about that. And then you'll also be prompted to select the company that you want to operate in. This is for organizations that maybe have multi-entities in them, and so they just want to make sure you're operating in the right company when making transactions. So first off, I'm going to be operating in the sample company today. The good thing about Stage 100 is that everyone will have an option for a sample company or a sandbox company. This is totally independent of your company, your live company that you do regular accounting in, but this already has fake data, fake employees, fake jobs. Everything is already set up as a demo for you guys to practice, get workflow training, and really, in my honest opinion, you can mess it up and there's no repercussion for it. So if you're wondering if something is a debit or a credit, you can definitely try it out in the sample company and get the answer before you have to post in your live company. So just for this example, we'll be operating in that company. Depending on your permissions, you can access this as an admin, so open company with administrator rights. That is if you are a company administrator that was set forth by your superiors. So sometimes you may not have these two boxes here, you'll just have the option to open. And then open company exclusively is more for year-end time when you only need one person in the software. So just for this example, we're going to open it with admin rights, and then everyone will default the same way. So on the left-hand column here, you'll have a system menu. Mine will look a little bit more extended than probably what your company will look like. This will include all of the modules that your company has access to. And then on the top, they are grouped together by like items. Oftentimes, Stage right now has little demos and modules that you haven't technically purchased yet, but it'll limit you on what you can do. So if you haven't purchased the equipment module, it may still be there, but you won't be able to get in it. So no need to be alarmed there. You might have a few extra ones to kind of play around with for a minute. And then, like I said, on top, you'll have the colorful icons, as I call them, to see more of the picture views of each of the items. But these are the equivalent of the ones on the left-hand side. From here, you have some different options to customize right off the bat, depending on what groups you're with. So you have what's called My Menu. And so if you are just doing project management and you don't necessarily need all the accounting fun stuff at the very bottom, you can exit out of these items and save it to where you don't see that anymore. You'll just see the items that you want to see. So it's more of a quicker option to just get the information that you need and operate in the modules that you need to operate in. Same thing on the picture icon. So to do the menu item, I clicked customize my menu. To do the icons and to delete that, these are called workflow paths. And so this is designed to be a quick hyperlink into the items that you want to quickly look at or edit something in. So in order to do that, you'll just do the click here hyperlink. And here you'll have some options. If you need to delete some items, you can delete them. And you can add in some more. If you need to put in some budgeting, you can put budgeting in here as well. So this is designed to help you guys create a more custom workflow path for yourself or the team that you're working with for quick and easy access. So everyone has that option designed for them. Let's go back to the general system menu that everyone will have access to. The system is set up to be an accounting software solution that also has a touch of project management in it. So in the core product itself, you'll have the ability to get financial data, get your reports, do some job costing, and then file taxes and print W-2s at the end of the year. So it's really accounting based, but it's more for the construction industry to have job costing for project management. So when we look at this, there are several different ways we can access the same item. So the core modules are the GL, accounting reports, AR and AP, payroll, and project management with some scheduling aspects of it. Utilities are just company information, so that'll come with every core package that's in the software. But to add on to have additional modules, depending on what your company specializes in, you can have equipment management, where you can track different company vehicles or pieces of equipment that you need to job cost and depreciate. Estimating, which is building bids, we call them takeoffs in the Sage world, and put those into project management. Service receivables, more for work orders and dispatching workers for 1 or 2 day type of gigs. Inventory, so you can manage the items that you have on hand and in stock in a warehouse. And then you'll also have the review and reporting. Everyone will have that. That comes with the out-of-the-box Sage 100 Con. So to break this down, there's really two different categories or two different types that I see here. I see the project management side, to do job costing, to get paid. And then I see the accounting side, to post transactions, to get employees paid. So here we can look at several different ways to go about doing that, but oftentimes we do have two different groups. Depending on security levels, you can set up specific employees to have different levels of permissions. That way that you don't have your project managers going into financial reporting data, you can limit them to the view-only side of it, to where they can only get the information they need and they don't necessarily have to feel like they have to edit things or filter through items to get the information they want. So like I said, this may look a little bit different depending on what modules your company has purchased, but this is just the kind of full comprehensive view of that. So here, just to go through the navigation side of it, you do have some support options readily available to you. So that's going to be under Home and Resources. So if you just kind of hover over this Home icon, the drop-down menu appears. My favorite is the Sage Support. And so there's a couple different tools here that are readily available. You have the Knowledge Base, which is my preferred tool. It's my Sage Bible, if you will. And so we'll have to get you guys credentials, but once you guys are logged on, and I'll go ahead and log into mine here, this is like Google for Sage 100. So if I wanted to know something about budgets and I didn't even know what I wanted to learn, I could type in budgets And it looks like there's 225 articles about budgets, how to create one, different codes that other people have asked questions on. You can review the article. The best thing about this, if I wanted to know how to create a budget, it will give me that article with the steps in order to do that one process. These articles are created specifically by Sage people, Sage experts in the software. And so it's a quick, easy tool so you don't have to spend and waste a lot of time researching this. The other tool that I love is the live chat. Depending on your maintenance plan with Sage, you can chat with somebody who is an expert in the software and say, why am I getting this error message? They'll either one, give you a knowledge base article, or two, set you up with somebody who would know exactly what you're going through and what the best answer, their best approach is. So those are the two support methods I would recommend. When we look at downloads and updates, that's more for the quarterly releases and the year-end updates to update tax tables. So we rarely use that one. We also have a user's guide. To be quite frank, this is about 1,200 pages of the user guide of Sage 100. So it can be pretty lengthy unless you know exactly what you're looking for. That's when I would recommend that knowledge base. Sage University is also a really good tool. It's more curriculum based, so it's a set of videos that would take you through a certain module in the software to give you tutorials and how-tos on that. That is a great tool as well. That's what a lot of our experts at Bangor learn off of for the very introductory 101 type of curriculum. So that's pretty much it for the resources on the home tab. This is where you'll find a lot of help topics or just general information. Clients and service is where, again, these items are grouped. And so if you wanted to go into, this is a good example here. So if we wanted to look at all of our jobs and just the job record itself where we entered in the information for it, we can double click here. But notice how when you pop this up, there's a menu item here. So 3-5, and then it gives the name jobs AR. That's going to give you the menu item over here. So 3-5, and that's jobs AR. It's going to take you to the same screen. So these screens, these items are really just meant to have a quicker access into the items that you're needing specifically for what you're doing. With vendors and purchasing, these are the items where you'll track your AP vendors and the purchasing or invoicing that you've sent out to them to get paid on. Projects. Just like usual, this is where everything is managed. So once everything is created on the job record itself, the jobs AR, this will have two different workflow paths designed. You can go into your subcontracts or you can go into your purchase orders. This workflow path is set more for a general contractor than anything else. So this may look a little bit different than what you're probably used to. But these workflow paths are designed to lay out a specific way that you're supposed to get from one place to the other. You can also put in reports or different tasks that you need to complete. Different reports or different accounting knowledge that you need to get the numbers that you're requesting. And then payroll. Payroll is going to be where you track all employees, where you put in time cards, and where you post and print your checks to the GL. And then everything else, like I said, is an add-on module. So on this banking and ledger, this is just your standard bank reconciliations and your journal transactions. So more on the accounting side when you transfer money between accounts within the same company. And then here, if we have inventory and equipment, this is where we'll track all of our parts and assemblies, but also depreciate our vehicles, just like we were tracking them against the job. Estimating and scheduling, there's a lot of different options for us on how we can track when and where we're going to start and stop our jobs. So we'll start by creating tasks, and then that will create Gantt charts for us to see when each task is going to be completed. Then we can put that against our budget that we did on our bid and against our proposal. So then we know our variance on if we're going to be over budget or under budget. Reports is the best way to track anything in Sage, in my honest and biased opinion, for sure. I love the reporting aspect because everything comes with a standard report. So most of the reports that you're probably used to pulling, Sage probably has some variance of that report. If you're not sure if that report exists, you can always do, there's a couple things. You can look at report and query list, and that'll give you all of your reports that you have access to without any customizations, how they look. So I can see all of my general ledger reports. I can see all of my accounting reports, and there's 33 pages of lists of reports that are able to be pulled at the click of a button. That's one of my favorite features, is if I don't know something exists, I can always try to find it. The admin report is more of the managing your company on the software side. So company information and then security groups, putting users to the right category of permission level they need, and making sure users can log in successfully to the software. From here, everything else can be managed on the database. So the software version that each user will be operating in is more for the day-to-day company financial, company project management type of workflow. At the end of each day, it's important that each user logs off successfully or closes out of Sage, because then that means that all records have been saved thus far. Because this is not a cloud-based software, this will need to be on a maintenance plan that was set up on your database on your server. And so that means that everything that you guys save is, one, stored on the database, but also backed up. So if something happens, everything that you guys have done for the previous day has been saved somewhere else, so you don't lose that progress. With that, typically that runs, depending on when your server backs up, between like 11 p.m. and 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. So everything is stored at the very end of the day. So when you're done for the day, make sure you exit out of here and say yes on exit stage 100. And you should be out of the software completely. Like I said, it's important that each user exits out of the software each night so it's updated and stored successfully. If you guys have specific questions on how to navigate into Sage 100, please let me know. If there's something that you feel like you should be able to see or do into Sage 100 that you're not able to do, that is probably a security group or a user permission level issue. And so the first step would be to ask your company admin for permissions for that. That's probably the number one solved problem that we get as Banger, is that somebody cannot access something, somebody's limited on what they're able to submit or save. And 9 times out of 10, it is a security group issue. But otherwise, navigation should be pretty free range unless you are restricted. If you guys have any questions or you want to dive deeper into that specifically on how to navigate in this, this was just a 101 kind of introductory into that. But if you want specific training for either a new user, a new group of users, or just kind of want to refresh with the basics, 100%. That is one of my biggest suggestions when we have either turnover in companies or people wanting to get reacquainted. My email, the best way to email me is coordinator@bangerinc.com, or call our 800 number on our website. I'd love to sit down and schedule a session with you guys to make this more company specific and geared for what your new user is going to be using it for. Otherwise, I will talk to you soon at our next class, or feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We upload content weekly that is more geared for a specific day-to-day and maintenance type of routine items. Thank you guys for tuning in, and I will talk to you soon.